Now in the shop today, I have a friend's airplane in for a V-tail tune-up, and this is a Yarrow-Mueller F3J. It's a 3.5 meter plane, and obviously a V-tail. Now the main complaint for the tuning on this airplane is that it has a lot of pitch up coupling. So anytime the rudder is used, either through the mix or through just left stick manipulation, nose really wants to pitch up. So it tells me that the V-tail differential is not set correctly. So we have more up in the rudder as we do a rudder movement, causing the airplane to pitch up more than it wants to yaw. So we want to kind of equalize that out. Now we can, you know, play with it mechanically, but you know, through the radio is really the best way to do it. Got the DS16 jetty here. So one of my first steps is going to be to go through the radio, make sure he's got this programmed right. I'm going to zero out all of the sub trims and servo movements and get that centered. So we want to make sure that the servos are moving in sync. We're going to maximize the mechanical setup for resolution and torque. And I think this plane is built pretty well, so I don't think we're going to have issues there. But I think there's some mechanical differential happening in the V-tail where we're getting more up than down. And I also noticed too, we got way too much up and down movement in the elevators too. So when we get that CG into that sweet spot where the airplane is going to read air really well and also launch really steep, that's going to be way too much throw. It's going to be too pitchy. So we're going to reduce that as well and then equalize the differential on the V-tail using the radio as the last step, using the V-tail screens on here. Because the early versions of software here didn't have a V-tail differential screen. They used a kind of a strange dual rate curve thing to adjust the volumes for left and right here. But now with the new software updates, they have a V-tail screen on here. And it's gonna get a lot easier to do the setup. So let's jump in. We're gonna do radio, mechanicals, back to the radio, and get this airplane dialed in. Now the first thing I want to do is go to the servo setup menus and set up our endpoints and look at our sub trims. And this is what I've found for elevator one, and there's elevator two, and that's the other side of the V-tail. So for one, we've got a sub trim at 13%. That's a good sign. If I saw this up at 75-80%, that means there's too much electronic sub trim being used for that servo. I'd want to recenter it, or maybe recenter the servo arm on the servo. 13% is not bad. We are going to select that and we're going to move it down to zero because we want everything centered out and equal. We also want to go max positive. Remember, we had tons of up and lots of down, so we want to back that off. So we're going to set these at let's just do 70. These are probably going to change. And this is our down travel here. Set this at minus 70. And this is actually, doesn't really show it in the radio, but this is for our actual rudder limits here. And we're gonna take those down to 70 as well. If we end up with percentages below 70 for any of these, we might wanna think about moving the clevis a little bit further inboard on that servo arm. But we'll start with 70 here, and that should be okay. So everything's centered out, and let's go to the next menu. So here's a close-up of the V-tail linkage coming back here. You know, very clever design, super clean, round push rod going into a flat section on the carbon, which has a pin in it, and that pin plugs into the horn here. There's absolutely no slop of the pin of the horn, which is a good thing because that causes all kinds of problems. So what's causing our mechanical differential? Well, that's because the horn, you know, it's super short here, so we're losing resolution. We don't have a lot of leverage over the surface, but also it's offset here. This is about a quarter inch back, an eighth inch or so, just far enough back that's causing this mechanical differential. So we're getting more up than natural down. So everything's zeroed out, and all our control volumes should be equal, but they're just not. So we need to get rid of that mechanical differential as we set up our V-tail volume throws so we get a little bit more down than up, but still have enough rudder control. So let's work on that next. Now most radios have a servo output screen. This shows you exactly what the radio wants to put out. It shows you the servo centers, and it shows you the output that the radio is putting out. Remember, this is what the radio is trying to put out. What you're getting in the airplane could be a little different because we're going through a mechanical system. This is showing me my pitch now, so I've got a little bit more up than down. That's all I want to see. But you can see these numbers are pretty low. I'm throwing away a lot of the servo resolution by not having these higher, and that's a mechanical issue. Let's go look at our rudder here. You can see these numbers are going to be a little asymmetrical because it doesn't take into account the subtrim numbers. But we have a little bit more down than up now. So pretty useful screen. If you're doing servo setups and want to know what the radio is at least trying to put out, the servo setup screen is pretty useful. Now it did take some work with the endpoint adjustments to get rid of all that mechanical differential and at least get the rudder veers moving in the right direction for more down than up. So here's our rudder now. Here's our up. It's got about 18. Here's our down. 20.6. So we've got a little bit more down than up. That's pretty close. That's a good starting point. Now it's time to get into that V-tail differential mix and start doing some tweaking because since I changed the endpoints, here's our up elevator, 11. So I probably want a little bit more than that. But here's our down. That twice as much down as up. And that's not the way I want it. I want to have a little bit more up elevator than down pitch. So get into that V-tail screen and start doing some adjustments there and see if we can get the volume straightened out and get the differential set in a final position. Now on this plane, we don't have a visual reference to line up the surfaces at the zero trim line to this foil. So we're going to use a straight edge to go across. And we're going from the high point of the foil here to the trailing edge in the back. And you can see where the three is. Got a little bit of light showing through and the reflections are touching. So that means we have a little bit of up in the back. Now since we have just a little bit of up, we're going to use the radio subtrim to correct that. If we had a lot of gap like that, we'd probably want to go in and mechanically recenter the clevises up front instead of using the subtrim. But since we're off, you know, maybe a degree or two, we're going to go ahead and use the subtrim. Okay, we have the subtrim selected. And let's reduce that. Now you can see how the ruler is touching all the way and the reflections are now matching. So that's our zero angle. And we just used 11% of subtrim, so that's not very much. And we're good to go. We'll do the same thing on the other side. My upcoming training video, Precision Tuning Techniques, will teach you advanced glider setup and evaluation skills that will help you get the most performance from any thermal or slope plane while also making it easier to fly. Subjects will include the myths of dive test, static margins and CG calculations, V-tail tuning, tuning setups unique to electrics, radio ergonomic improvements, and how to apply a flight testing workflow to quickly get your plane tuned for maximum performance. Until the Precision Tuning Techniques video is released, you can get it at the special pre-order price of only $18.95, and that's either for the HD digital download or the DVD. Go to my site, radiocarbonart.com, to pre-order your copy of this highly useful video training program that will surely help you get the most from any glider you fly.